Baptist, Table 8. Rhiannon Bolton, Victoria. Rachel King, WA. Rhiannon, your first practice. Master Single, sub-3. Steve Gray, Victoria. Chris Snare, Tasmania. Steve, your first practice. And Table 1, Russell Yilton, South Australia. John Russell, Victoria. Russell, your first practice, Table 3.
Are you all here, hopefully?
No.
Gordy's here.
Yeah, the guys played today. If you have a need to wrap your own balls, you can go down by the road.
please change over. Thank you.
You got a ball marker? I put them all out the other day. There's got one inside, man.
Is it okay if I'm on?
did it.
Umpires, please take control of the tables and prep them for the rest of the singles. Thank you.
If we have anybody who look like the umpire one of the ladies' matches, that would be much appreciated, please. An umpire for the ladies' match.
So, 1 point. I I 30 seconds.
No, I'd go for five.
Red Bulls in play. Seconds. seconds.
I'm running.
Put someone to break, at least one, at least two frames to one. Time running.
No, wait.
Come on, Wes!
No, mate.
Flip up.
Ready? seconds.
30 seconds.
Go
30 seconds.
Yeah.
Yeah, I vote nominated.
30 seconds.
We vote to fight. 30 seconds. Yeah, I vote to fight.
Thirty seconds.
One sec, guys.
Come on, sec, guys.
I
Yellow balls in play.
Go, super.
Thirty seconds.
Come on, sweetheart. morning, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry for the late commentary, but I am not sleeping well at the moment. Need some shut-eye. We are going to focus more on the Kurt Dunham-Steve Saxon match, purely because it is further away from the commentary area than the Michael Scarry-Jake McCartney match, so they'll be in earshot of some of the things I say, so it's better to focus on the other match. I've heard there's been a couple of interesting developments already in these matches. And Kurt looks like he's in a touch of trouble this frame. He's going to need to try and find a way to develop this red, or probably play the double now. I don't actually, when I look at this, I don't think he has a choice but to play the double now. Oh, you just saw on the bottom left of your screen, Jake McCartney just played a massive split again. He really is a freak at getting splits. And Kurt's just sizing this shot up because it's a big shot. He misses this shot, he's going to lose the frame and will be in arrears. So he's just hit it, I reckon, just a touch hard, to be honest, because they straighten up so much the doubles, but he was trying to pull the wide out as well in a favourable position for his next red, so it was a tough shot there because the red straightens up off the back cushion, and if he hits it at the angle to actually counter that, he probably cannons into the yellows of the white when he's coming back, so... Steve Saxon should make no mistakes here. Just needs to negotiate a couple of, like small little obstacles, nothing too major. Well, he's somehow picked the gap there. He would have liked a little nudge on one of those yellows there, probably the bottom of the two. Actually, I've just looked at the table itself. I don't know how he's got through that gap. Tell you what, if I'm Steve, I'm not very happy with letting Kurt back to the table here. Even though that black's in a pretty nice position for Steve, it's you allow someone like Kurt Dunham a chance to get extraction. There's every chance he may get it. We're not playing our local league pool anymore. If you watched the quarterfinals yesterday, you would have seen some very, very big extraction type shots and positional shots. So Kurt's just hasn't quite got into that as much as he would have liked, I don't think. I'm pretty sure he was trying to land a little square to that red and then he was going to play for the extraction off two rails, and then he has the red over the pocket as a backup ball. He still may play it. Actually, I'm just looking at the angle on this. It's too thin to cut into the corner. So he's going to be playing the red over the cushion and trying to get a position for extraction. The problem with the extraction on this is he needs to come off the back cushion to push the black away from the yellows. If I was a betting man, I would actually say that Steve Saxon will get back to the table. But I just wouldn't put me house on it. And he wanted to be off the rail there. And he's also got not enough angle, he's too straight. But he just can't dig into the white now. So I think the best that Kurt can do here is just to try and line him up on some sort of double on the black. So I'm pretty sure Kirsch is going to drop this in. He places the power, makes the shot even more difficult, and see, he's tried to manufacture some kind of angle that probably wasn't really there, and he's missed the pot. So Steve Saxon's pretty much got all his balls over the hole and shouldn't miss this out. Jake McCartney snookered himself over on these other table. That's a really poor shot from Steve. He should just be nowhere near that whatsoever. If he's actually still on his yellows, he's probably a bit fortunate, but... Well, another shot for Kurt Dunham. Not an easy ball to have to pot and get around the angles and get position, though. And given Kurt, we have plenty of nicknames for our Vic boys from year to year, but Kurt's is now Kurt Cuddles Dunham. I'm not going to tell you why that is.
30 seconds.
So big shot coming up here for Kurt. And he's just overcut it. I can actually tell you, on these particular tables, that's actually a really big shot. It's they're very jawy, these pockets, if you don't hit them absolutely spot on. Just a quick shout out to a close friend of Kurt's, actually, who I have affectionately given the nickname of Tappet. She'll know who she is. Hello, Tappet. So Steve Saxon now should this time make no mistakes, and he's landed nicely on this yellow and will screw back and land just off straight on the last ball on the rail. That's perfect as well, and he will take a 3-2 lead, barring a miracle. Say, just quickly looking at this frame, Scarry's played some very good shots to get himself back into this. He was in all sorts when Jake snookered him off too, and he's got out of the snooker and played a very good shot. And now he's favourite this frame at the moment. That's a pretty good shot too, but has freed up the black. Just in case you're, both the AABF stream is running as well, doing the girls matches. If you're obviously just tuned into this one, you don't know the scores. Rio Bolton from Victoria's 4-0 down on Rachel King from WA, 4-1 down. The other match, Lyndall Hulley is beating Lauren Jelly 3-1 at the moment. So another excellent shot there from Mick, making sure that Jake doesn't have a clean shot. I mean, Jake can hit this yellow, but it's not really to his advantage, and the good thing for Mick there is he hasn't actually left him another total for Jake to come off a cushion and rest behind the yellow, so it's worked out beautifully for him. And we'll just flick back to the other mats just purely because it's further away. It's the only reason, guys. I know a lot of you probably want to watch the Vic match because, you know, a lot of the guys tuning in are Vic. So I've just had the nod from Mick. He's not real fast, so we'll see how this frame pans out, and if it's doesn't look like it's going to develop quickly, we'll flick out the other match. But you can still see it in the bottom left of your screen. And Jake's actually played a really good shot too. He's really in trouble, but he's keeping himself in the frame by playing some excellent shots. And it's forcing Mick to play equally good shots. So Kurt just has this one red that's to the left of the table now, that I believe he's on, but it's pretty thin to the middle. And he's just sizing up. He's not sure if he likes it or not. I think the main reason is the positional value offered afterwards. He'd have to give it a little bit just to clear the white away from the little clusters down here. And he's potted and he's cleared the red. And now Kurt has heaps of options. He's on, you know, sort of three or four balls. And it's just a matter of him mapping this out. Because everything's on, even the red that's near the yellow is on. So, on the right side of the table I'm talking there. So he's just going to eliminate this one ball he's right on now. And so what Kurt's doing here is he's basically eliminating one end of the table, and he's just going to work his way up and just basically be in a situation where he can play a little controlled stuns and roll-ins. Just the way Kurt's taking so long with this, I think maybe he doesn't quite have the angle that he wants. If he had a screwed back another even inch, he probably would have had angle just to screw out or stun out, sorry, past the black. He may have to actually force it a little bit. The way he's queuing, this looks like he's got angle, so he's just forced it a touch, so it's a nice shot. It's really a stun run through that shot, and he's perfectly on this ball on the rail now. And this was all about him working out his transition for these three balls, because even though they look all simple, this can go wrong very quickly if you don't get it right. Shot, and he has deliberately left this red that's near the yellow to last, and he'll want to get as straight as he possibly can without having to foul. And in the bottom of your screen there, Scary's actually made a very good clearance to level up at 4-all, and now Kurt trying to do the same to level up at 3-all. Don't say really anything going wrong, and he should just be able to get through this enough to just clear the yellow. I think he's just going to roll this in and just come off the yellow a touch, and he's just checking now with the white. The way he's looking at this, he may be considering just stunning the red in and just pushing the yellow out of the way, but I thought he'd be better off just to glance past it and put the black in the opposite middle pocket. But, look, we could have, you know, it's hard to read exactly what he's got on the camera. Well, he's just... It was actually tougher than I thought because he was catching the yellow very full. But he probably need to just give it a bit. So I let off there for Kurt, and Steve Saxon will probably feel a little bit better in his chair right now. Butters has decided to whack on the headset and join me in commentary.
30 seconds.
How you going, Butters?
Thanks, Solid. Just waiting for a few more people to turn up so there was enough noise in the room to commentate.
Yeah, sounds like you've got the throat thing going as well, mate.
Nah, mate, just trying to be quiet. I'm the only non-sick person in the Victorian contingent. not sick in the body, anyway.
Well, we're all sick in the mind.
For all Jake and Scary.
Yeah, this is actually... I haven't got here from the start of this match. From what I've seen, the quality and the standard's been quite high.
Well, Scary didn't make a mistake in the first three frames. Jakey's played pretty well to come back. There's a couple of little errors from Michael. Just had to swap mics because apparently I'm a quiet talker.
And that's not hard to believe given that you part that up with me.
Yeah, I suppose in comparison, not many people would be loud next to you, Jamie.
And they'll find that out today as well at 2 o'clock.
Yes, indeed. Steve Saxon's got his nose back in front.
I'll tell you what, Mick's playing some of the best ball I've ever seen him play at the moment.
I've said it a few times now, he's as determined as I've seen him in a couple of years, mate.
So close.
Might get it this time. Oh my god. Can't believe you tried to hit that off six cushions.
Yeah, I've probably just gone the simple route. Just a little bit of work to do here for Saxon. I mean, they're all on, yes, and you'd like to just keep your two on the black, but it's going to be a series of good little pots and controlled positional shots to just make those pots a bit easier. So
I think if Kurt had stayed in front in this match, he'd be a huge favourite. Steve's a dangerous player.
Yeah,
if he gets comfortable,
he's not going out now. I promise you, look for another snooker. I can't believe he didn't take the ball in the middle first end, but it is thinner than it looks on camera at the table where he was playing from.
That'll give Kurt a bit more confidence too.
There's the other snooker. It's really, pretty good snooker, actually.
Yeah, it is, but he's only developed one ball. He could have done more than that.
He could have, but at the end of the day, sometimes it's a matter of the turtle beating the hare, and unless Kurt gets out of this and flicks it, Steve's not going to be stressed because he's still in a very dominating position.
Now, Jamie, we all know it's a tortoise, not a turtle.
Mate.
Come on.
It's been a while since I've done the kids' stories.
Steve Gray on the black. Oh my god. That's as uncharacteristic as you get.
I actually picked Steve Gray to smash Chris Snare about 8-1.
Yeah, so did I, but he played out of a snooker earlier. Chris had dead balls all over the table, and he's played out of a snooker, nicked the red and knocked the black all the way down the table.
Look how ridiculously stiff that is.
That's very unlucky.
I don't know how many times I see people come out of a snooker, play a really good shot, and then get punished for no reason whatsoever, other than something hates them.
He needs to open these up now.
He's certainly done that.
Well, yeah, he's still got a little bit of work to do. He may take the cherry here, Jamie.
think, and get on that ball better, no? He's going to take it here. I think this is like the, I'll be potting this ball down the bottom and then having a free shot at this ball at the top. If it sits over the hole, then I'll play the plant. Although what he's done here is actually fine as well.
It is, but he still could have had a fair dinkum crack at potting that, and he didn't. There was no conviction in that shot at all.
Yeah, right, he was happy to put over the hole, but he's a very stable player, Steve.
I know it's no big deal that he should go out, but say he does hit this and not well, and he lands long on the one down the rail, all of a sudden he's got a pressure shot.
He's played it very well.
Yeah, he's fine anyway.
I would actually like to have been less straight than this, though.
Doesn't matter, he's got the ball across anyway, so.
Yeah, but I don't want to be on the rail playing it.
Yeah, he probably didn't want that in. The second ball, that is.
Oh, a bit of hesitation, but I've watched Steve Sachs play a lot. He doesn't actually chop up very much under pressure. He's a pretty solid player.
Very good player. Jake's just knocked a beautiful ball down the rail to see.
Yeah, and there is a gap, but definitely not for where that red's sitting. So Steve's actually he's left himself more than he had to do with a cue ball there, but he's played a fantastic shot, very well controlled.
Yeah, very good.
Made it look easier than it actually was. And he will go 4-2 up.
Yeah. Still a long way to go, but that's a nice little cushion.
And I think I know Steve Saxon's made a lot of quarterfinals. I'm not sure if he's actually made a semi before, but I have seen usually exit tournaments at quarterfinals or earlier stages, so I don't know if he's in new waters or what.
I can say 100%, Jamie, that I have no idea. and of that I am sure.
Steve Saxon's 4-2 on Kurt Darm now.
Russell and Russell and JR, 3-2 to Russell.
That is 3-2.
No, I thought it was already 3-2.
I was sure it was already 3-2.
Yeah, no, it is 4-2 now to Steve Saxon.
Technical difficulties, Judah.
I made a comment earlier that Kurt was making the out to level the match, so.
This is typical of Dan Lynch messing with our heads. Jake in pretty good position here.
He's just going to smash this and try and get a result.
That's all he could do.
Can't blame him.
Yeah, this will be 5-4 Jake unless he falls over and breaks his leg.
I'll tell you something about Jake.
Nothing personal, I hope.
No, I told him to put some cream on that, but he actually has a bit of a tendency to get a little bit lazy in the middle of matches. And some people will recognise this that do take advantage of it, and other people just think, I'll stiff or whatever, because, they've had their chance and not got it. But you will find, here and there in a match, you will get a bit lazy and give you a chance.
I believe that to be true as well, but I don't think so from 3-love down.
Well, when he played Rusty yesterday, he played definitely at least one careless shot that I could pick up, and it let Rusty right back in the match.
So he played one careless shot in a race to 9, did he? That's terrible.
Missing my point, mate. It's something that he actually is aware of himself and wants to cut out of his game.
That's a good recovery shot.
Very good shot. And he will just drop this in and land straight on the other ball in the middle.
He would have liked to go a couple of inches further, but that'll do.
He always wants to do that, but he will have an easy black for 5-4 up.
So 5-4 Jake versus Scary. Steve Saxon breaking at 4-2. And he has come up dry.
Yeah, very important for Kurt to take advantage of this.
Yes, massive frame for Kurt.
And I can actually tell you now, there's a lot of talk around the room last night and odds and who was favourite and all that kind of stuff. And in the majority of people's eyes, Kurt was an enormous favourite over Steve Saxon. As I said to so many people in the past, he's the most, I reckon he's actually the most underrated player at national title level.
I think, look, I honestly believe Kurt is favourite. And not only, not just favourite, but he should go in favourite. He's current Australian champion. No doubt he should be favourite.
Well, the but line was 3.5.
But looking around at all the matches, the only match I could see that there was a real outright favourite in was probably Steve Gray and Chris Snare.
Yeah, that's a fair call.
It wouldn't shock you which way any of the other matches went.
Well, I predicted Kurt to win 9-6. I didn't even bother predicting the Scary McCartney match because it's two Vics and I just don't want to be involved in any type of prediction.
No.
To be honest, they're the only two matches I looked at. I didn't actually look at any other lineup or other matchups.
Alright. This is one of those outs where it's easy if you keep landing right. I know that sounds stupid and obvious, but the balls aren't open. But if you keep landing well, it can be pretty easy.
You're right. It looks a little bit congested, but what Butters said is spot on. One good positional shot, and it actually will open up the other balls. I just wonder if he's thinking about going into these. He doesn't actually need to.
Well, I think he wants to open that pocket up for the red touching the yellow in the middle of the table.
Yeah, what's he playing after it?
He needs to get into the yellow here. No, he's just going to...
Just left himself a reasonably...
Well, the plant might be on Jamie.
Playing, isn't he? He's actually able to run the wider touch.
Pretty warm down in this corner, Jamie. Sorry, mate. Yes, welcome to Dan Lynch's sauna. It is very warm in this corner of the room. Jamie's just ripped the headphones off to have a chat for a minute. It left me hanging. This is pretty much the key shot for Kurt. If this goes right, he'll be fine. So, money shot. Oh, he might have to play another one here. I've got to say, is it?
Steve's doing everything at the moment. He's just knocking blokes' beers up while he's playing. And
I was just mentioning how warm it is in this corner of the room, Jamie.
Yeah, look, it's not cold.
Then you rip the headphones off and started chatting to someone else, and I'm waiting for a response.
Well, Connie's just come over to me because he wants to discuss the lineup for today's match. So right. It's a little bit different with the four-round format than the three. We've got to actually rejig the side since we're the away team.
Kurt's played the plant and left himself another one.
It's very hard if it goes past.
It's very hard for this to go right.
Oh, wow.
And be left with a shot. Well, he's left with a shot. He's left with a double.
Yes.
Which, if it goes, he should be fine. The white should run off the cushion and catch the yellow about half ball or just miss it. And he will have a shot in the black if it drops.
I'll tell you what, I don't know if you guys have noticed on the screen, but there's these big sunlights in the roof. And when the sun's right out, so much light comes into the room and it gets hot as hell. And when the clouds come over, it gets darker in the room and instantly start to feel a bit better.
Always seems to shine down on McCartney, doesn't it? Makes his massive head glow.
It is not a small cranium, I think. And that is
That's a very good shot from Kurt. That's huge.
And this is what this bloke does.
He will be feeling a lot of relief right at the moment after leaving himself that shot.
That's why this guy is the current Australian singles champion. And he's missed.
Oh, he's just lifted the head on that. Yeah, he dropped the shoulder.
He moved a lot. And Steve Saxon with a chance to almost close the match out after a shot, because that is debilitating to your confidence.
That's a big confidence swing right there from both players. If Steve can take advantage of this, it'd be be very hard for Kurt to get back. Steve will be flying.
And you can see the WA shirts there. They've decided they'll put the number 2 on their shirt this year, on the front.
It is quite amazing how much that number 2 looks like a swan too, Jamie.
Incredible, isn't it? But I'm going with the number 2.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
I'm actually going to try and get a WA shirt. I've always been a big fan of WA shirts.
I've been trying to myself.
And I'll tell you something else I like about it. Just from a purely self-gratification point of view, Bubba, is when, and this doesn't happen very often, but when I do actually make the stream stages of a tournament, the WA shirts look really good.
No, they don't look as good as a navy blue, mate.
I'm just talking the non... Great shot from Kurt.
Well, that's a huge error from Zacko there.
That was.
He's had the chance to really put the boot in then.
And this frame's been actually going a little bit longer than I expected it to. I thought this would have got, they would have sorted this out by now, but... Oh, actually, sorry, I'm thinking of the previous frame. Jesus.
I've got VJ standing behind me, making me a bit uncomfortable, Jamie.
That's actually a very bad shot from Jake. He will not be happy with that shot at all. Now, you're probably wondering why Jake's hit that so hard. He's done it purely just to get a good white. But the problem is, he wanted to hit the ball full and he's caught it thin and the red's flying up the table.
That's a big shot.
And that's a very nice, clean
fantastic
pot from
Scary
there. And he is on this ball in the middle, and he will have enough angle to come out between the gap and be on this red.
That's just confidence in your cueing to be able to hit that shot at that weight.
Absolutely.
Just a little punch shot here, and should be fat in the middle, Jamie.
Let's Steve grab the top. He needs no rest. He just leans over full length of the table and just plays little shots.
Yeah.
Not a care in the world.
The guy's an absolute freak show.
Actually,
that.
That was JR, actually. Yeah, the elder mistake JR was Steve Gray.
Yeah, that's quite unbelievable, actually. May as well get Gordon and Tanya mixed up.
Race to 9. Kurt Dunham, first at the table again, and a chance, although he's just overscrewed his first shot.
Finding it a little bit strange that people are gathering behind us to watch when the table's right in front of them, but...
Happens every year.
To each their own.
Happens all the time. And Kurt just wanted to be probably half a foot to the left of where the white is now, so he had an angle to stun up the table. Now he's sort of going back towards the bulk line.
Well, looks any way he goes here, he may have a plant unless the ball he's looking at's on.
I'm pretty sure that does go.
Yeah, probably. Oh, he's just okay. But he's still going to be left with the same problem. If he's straight enough, he can run through, but if it's off angle a little bit.
Not afraid to leave the cue on the table and lift the butt of the cue after he's played the shot, is Kurt Dunham.
No, well, as Benny named him at Polo, we call him the fencer. He does do the little fencing technique when he's watching a shot go down.
It's funny, when he actually like misses a ball and he does lift the like leave the tip on the table and lifts the butt of the cue up, I swear I saw Benny do that first before anyone else. I'm sure of that.
Have you seen him do the full one where he lifts the butt of the cue up and turns around while it's still there and walks off with it hanging on his shoulder? That's pretty cool.
Yeah, the fisherman. Yeah. I've seen that one.
It's from fencer to fisherman.
It's actually really... it's actually very interesting to look at the traits players have when they make errors and see the facial expressions or the body language. There's a lot of really cool ones out there.
I'm not sure if I make any other than quite a little bit of abuse at myself.
You just look angry. I know I look at the roof. They all just stare out into the sunset.
Brenton does the best look at the roof of all time. Head up to the side and then can literally walk around the table without looking where he's going. And then the old classic handshake, two good class above.
Yeah, two good class above. Look away handshake is and the wet fish. It's
fair bit of work to do here for Sacco.
Yeah, and
what he will not be doing is opening the black up.
No, he's a very basic player, Sacco, and he'll just put this ball down the rail. Geez, that break just didn't come out.
I actually jumped when he hit them.
I'll tell you what, I'm actually surprised Jake hasn't requested to do his own racks, because he is not, I don't think he's actually had a good result with a single one accord over racks.
Mate, I saw a pretty funny thing yesterday. Michael Scarry asked if he could rack his own balls, and the umpire said no. So we went and checked, and it turned out he could. He asked Elliot Evrenatis, and the umpire looked over at Alex. Elliot gave him just a tiny nod, and the guy goes, no worries. So we all know who's in power in this thing. Just a tiny nod from Alex, and everything's fine.
Well, and if you didn't know Alec, you'd swear he'd be a member of the Mafia. So I wouldn't mess with him either. Who knows what connections that bloke's got.
What he says goes. So
you'll kill a horse and put the head in your bed if you're not careful. That's a very good shot from Curtin. Just a touch
not
stiff.
Quite got away with it.
This black though this is just dead.
This opens this frame right up here.
Actually, that black does double in the middle, I'd lie.
Kurt may have to play this bottom of the two in the middle, then try and get this yellow back across.
I think he's actually got an angle now, but it's where he can actually, if he's feeling all right, he can actually probably stun this ball into the middle of the three and land on this bottom one. That's what he's doing. He's going to stun this in the middle and just try and get pretty straight on this bottom yellow. And that's just overstunned.
There's the fencer.
He's decided to give the tip a workout on the cloth. Just polishing the cloth with his tip.
So, just for those who didn't hear, the fencer is not a good thing. Generally the shot hasn't worked.
McCartney just missed a 25 ball plant there.
Unlucky. So does he have enough on it?
I think he can hit it.
If he can hit it, he's a good chance of getting it there.
No matter if he can control the white stun up into the red above the yellow, because I don't think he can really hold the white perfectly. Well, he's let it go a bit.
That's great.
That's a great shot.
Because he wanted to be on that side, and it was hard to get on that side without getting contact on it. So.
Yeah. Does he play the cannon here, Butters, or does he just stun off two and play for the double? I like playing for the double here purely because you know you're going to get a shot.
You're going to get a shot at it, yeah, it's fair call.
Because if you cannon the black, there's no guarantee you're going to have a shot at it.
Yeah, how many times do you see him? You get contact on it, just push it past the red and be snookered or something like that.
Exactly right, but I reckon he's taking the cannon on here because he's been lined it up. Even a cannon on the red full will be okay because the action is still on the black.
Just make sure you punch this enough to widen it.
Oh, that's a very good shot.
Break shot.
And he will.
Sensational
he will put
shot
in the middle.
Great result, no fencer required.
Well, actually, if I misread this, I thought he put in the middle, but I might be wrong.
No, it's a fair way back from the middle. It's a very tough angle. A lot harder than it looks on the screen.
Yeah, you're right.
He can play it up the top with Sacco's got the red up there.
He's actually checking the middle now. So,
blind pocket angle in these, mate.
Yeah, with a shorter shot, you can play dead weight. If you get the angle right, you know it's going to go in. He's playing the middle, so this is probably how I'd play it too, to be honest.
It's a very big shot.
Oh, he's fouled. Okay, in hindsight, playing to the corner is probably the better shot. He's just done to hit that a touch.
Rio Bolton has just come back to 5-3 from, I think she was 4-1 or 5-1 down. 4-1,
I think. She was 4-1 down.
against, is it Rachel King, I believe?
Yep.
Yes, yeah, so she's on the way back, which is good. Good for Victorians, anyway.
Good opener there from Saxon.
Yeah, he's a lot straighter than he'd want to be.
Also, I'll kill me.
You seem to be, Darwin seems to be doing that fine just by itself, mate. Two shots, shouldn't have a drama here.
And Butters, this is where before in the last frame you said like you didn't have a fair nick and crack. This is, you've got to actually have a fair nick and crack this and want to pop this. And this time he has.
Yeah, that's a good shot.
Like even if it goes over the hole, he's still fine, but he actually played to pop that.
Yeah, and they should be easy, but one little thing goes wrong and you got one shot instead of two, makes it harder.
30 seconds.
Steve Gray looks to be grabbing another frame over there.
Big shot from Skerry, directly left your screen.
Directly behind Tanya.
Look at this shot from Skerry. What a shot.
Oh, that's huge. And this is exactly what I'm talking about.
Wow.
Had he not put the conviction into that first shot, and he's got one shot now. Even there, you get a kick or something. And,
good recovery shot.
It was. Nice pace.
We'll go 5-3 up.
5-3 Saxon, 5-3 Steve Gray. 6-5 Michael Skerry. Big finish. So there we are. Russell Yorton still 3-2 up against JR. JR's in control on the yellows, two balls left. Yeah, apparently me being the non-drinker in the, well, I'd say in the team, but it's probably in the entire carnival, are the only one who hasn't gotten sick yet.
So. But the only smoker in our team. Makes no sense, and we've all got a throat thing going. I feel like I need one of those things to put in my mouth so I can, to my throat so I can talk.
Some people God likes and some he doesn't, mate.
Hello, Butters. And a big break.
Huge break.
Mick.
Has been a bit stiff where he's landed, actually. Just giving him about 1, 2, 3, 4, 0 options. I think he's got the red up the top and that's about it.
Actually, I think he can pop this yellow over the hole. I think he can pot it.
Or the cannon. JR with the black to draw even. Damn you, camera angle.
I was actually fortunate enough to be able to have a look behind that at the table itself, so.
Here goes the black, and he's made no mistake. Queuing like in the 90s, JR.
So a little bit of work here to do for Mick, just purely because of that one yellow at the top end of the table. He's going to want to land on that neatly.
Well, I reckon.
We've had the question, how many balls, pool balls that is, do you think Tanya Matt could fit in her hand?
I'm going with 1.5.
I'm going to go with 1.25. Mick will be potting this, landing on the bottom rail, screwing up the rail.
Yeah, you just stand up the side, just got to make sure he doesn't get caught between the two up the top right.
Yeah, this is actually, this is tricky still, because he actually wants to be on the left side of the table a little bit. But
I think the best ball to play is the one over the hole now, because then you've got a natural run through to get on it, off the one down in the left here. I think it's safer. Bigger area and a good direction into it.
Yeah, I agree with you, but this feels, I think the reason most people take this route, like if they're out there, is it feels safer.
You can actually punch this, stun this off two cushions, go around those reds, but no, you're going to go that way. It's just, you've got a small line to get up there.
Yeah, Yeah, the danger of this is you just don't want to be running into reds.
This was so much easier off that last ball he just potted.
Tell you what, if you're a freak, you play this off two rails where you just missed in off of the centre pocket, past the pocket, and then come behind the yellow and land on that way. But that requires some pretty good control.
Just going to miss those reds by the small amount possible.
And how's this red? Has it come into play? He stamps his cue and gets the desired result.
See, if you go the other way there, there's almost no danger.
Well, he's got a pretty good shot at this yellow. And
can he hold?
That's the question. If he can't hold, you have to play the double, but I think he's confident he can hold.
I don't reckon he can. He's going to have to go across. Oh,
he plays those drag shots very well, Scary.
Yeah, that's a good drag. Proud of the drag shot.
And Scary takes it to McCartney. 6-all.
Try 7-5, mate.
7-5, in fact. Too much lack of sleep.
Alright, I'll just switch back over for a minute, Dan, thank you. Not really. I'm as exciting as balls getting racked up. Gordo doing a superb job.
Tell you what, it does not mind filling out the camera, does the big fella? Having a fair crack sporting that Mitchell logo on his back.
Kurt at the table. Balls look horrible everywhere.
I'll tell you what, mate, if you actually turn your stream on and saw Blair racking the buzzer, you'd swear you're watching a horror movie. Those shirts, I don't know what they're thinking. I'm sorry, they're terrible.
Yeah, probably not the colour I would have picked, Jane.
Pretty sure they have that colour like nearly every year, too. Big opener from Kurt.
Great opener.
But these balls are terrible.
Angle just to open these up, the red and the yellow near the pocket.
Yeah, this is, these balls are just boobers.
Yeah, they're not flash.
And I'll promise you there is not a single player at the current level in the room playing that wants this sort of frame. They want the balls a bit more open. Or if that had just stayed up,
Well, I tell you what, he's got the angle to cut it. I'll just poke my head over. He can cut this in and slide up and down.
He's going to have to hit with a bit of bone. McCartney has missed a pretty simple ball.
I reckon he's a chance of getting these, Kurt. Opening them up, that is. How it lands if he does get them will depend on whether he can go. But
well, here we go.
Chris. No, here we go.
Oh, he's actually got into it too much.
He needs to get up. He needs to go.
But even this, he can't actually get into the yellow off this.
Well, you maybe can. Got to hit the absolute crapper out of it.
Well, yeah, you got to force the black into him, though.
Feeling a bit sorry for Chris Nair over there. He's missed his last red, and Steve's got all these balls on the table. He's not the player you want to do that against.
He doesn't mind throwing a snooker on Steve Gray when he wants to. And the reason Kurt's playing this ball is because there's no way he can get contact on it for the other yellow. So he's just going to try and play a safety. Oh, it hasn't worked out how we wanted.
Well, he's got a bit of luck there, and those have landed together.
Yeah, he would have liked the white on the bottom rail, but Steve Sexton has lots of options here as well.
Chris playing there, not even bothering to play out of the snooker, trying to put the black onto the yellow and pot it, but it didn't knock it in, so Steve Gray should go game from here. Should put him 6-3 up. Russell Yorton and JR are just getting as much table time as possible.
No surprises there. So,
yeah, that could have been better.
It's a pretty good shot there from Steve, actually. Rio's made a comeback, 5-4.
5-4. We have no idea about the other one, which is Lyndall Hulley.
Lauren Jelly.
And Lauren Jelly. Yeah.
When we come away to Nationals, mate, we only care about Victorians.
Yeah. I know we're terribly biased commentators, but you know what? And we do it all the time, so we'll do what we want. How selfish are we?
And I'm actually going to take a punt and say that more than 50% of the viewers are probably Victorian.
That's a really good shot from Kurt there.
It was a good shot. 5-2 to Lyndall, which has been told. Oh, McCartney's going in off. And
he double kissed it.
Does not look himself at the moment.
I'll tell you what, he might have that might have actually put the snake in. This is all right for Kurt. He can just play it off one cushion, nudge it, leave the light in the back cushion. Excuse Jamie, coughing again.
Oh, I'm so sorry, guys. I just can't stop it.
He's on his deathbed and he's still dragged himself up to commentate for us all, so appreciate it, please.
So scary with two. He's playing too well to make a mistake here as well.
Yeah. Bit of work to do here, Michael. He may even be able to have enough, get enough on that red to play it off the yellow. But
yeah, it's pretty close, and I think he just needs to be simple about this out and not worry about trying to get all these cannons and stuff like that.
Mind you, it's not a bad ball to try and nudge into with the benefit of the red to the right of it where it is.
Well, he might be having a dip in it now.
Yeah, I reckon it's pretty safe.
He's played that with excellent control.
You've landed fat on the other one, so.
A lot of people would have blasted into that, I reckon. Try to get, you know, all this separation, but that just shows right there. Well, if you can get a cannon, you only need a small amount of separation.
Yeah, his main issue was controlling the white ball, which he did perfectly, so.
He's just under hit that a touch. Actually, you know what, he's probably over screwed it a touch. Yeah, just bear in mind, he's still got two shots, so.
Yeah.
But he just would have loved to have gotten an angle just to stun down the table, just so it's just so much more easy for him. And he's just playing with the idea of potting this ball now.
I think you'll play this off the yellow.
No, I reckon you'll commit to the pot.
I just think if you play it off the yellow, you can't draw it and sit it behind the yellow. Screw off one cushion.
Yeah, with side. And that's a very good shot. Mick, he looks like he's killing Bruni out there at the moment.
Probably play this with a touch of he's just gonna punch it straight out. See? That's my issue there, Jamie. You play that off the yellow, that doesn't happen.
I don't think he fully committed to that. I really don't, because if he fully commits to that and just lands behind the black, I don't reckon he misses that. I think he just has a real, real small lapse of concentration there. And it only takes a very minor lapse for something like this to happen.
Okay.
Jakey's trying to mess up the feed by pulling wires out.
It's like I'm 7-5 down, I'm not watching this, boys.
Kurt's got a chance of going.
Oh, he's hit it too hard. It's not the worst result in the world, but he would like to have stayed there.
It's a bit stiff, he hit that well too.
So Jake needs to still play a good out though.
And that could be a huge missed opportunity. It could be very costly.
Actually, there's a huge gap behind the back of his black. Didn't see that, and he's just made sure he's punched him out and developed the balls.
Now, Rio Bolton, sorry, anyway, went by her maiden name. She's back to 5-all, mate, so a huge comeback there.
And she's done the opposite of what she's been doing in her previous singles matches, where she's led a huge and then let them get back. She's doing the opposite now, yeah. Showing a bit of both ways.
And 6-2 to Lindell. And this will be a snooker all day long.
Don't be surprised if he doesn't.
Well, he can run it down and play a shot to nothing.
I reckon McCartney will have a dip at this.
Down the rail, shot to nothing.
Yeah, he'll just start back a little bit for the yellow in the middle.
JR's just knocked in his large yellow, and he's fat on the black. JR's about to go 4-3 up. Unmissable black.
Well, he's actually going to play this in the promotional yellow shot. And that's missed. And Scurry has a chance for a big full-length double.
And I played one of these last night trying to cover the hole and it went straight in. Very annoying.
These shots on these particular tables are actually very hard just because of how much they straighten up. I've never actually seen anything like it.
Yeah, and saying that, the angle he's on, he's almost got to hit this dead straight.
Which means he needs to aim a little bit wide.
No, I'm saying...
Oh, how has Kirk got back into this frame?
Yeah, well, Sacco's made big errors letting him back into this.
Very good position shot there from Kurt as well. And, well, he did. He hit it wide trying to straighten it up.
Oh, I tell you what, if that nicked the wide, it was straight in.
Kurt Dunham, this is actually a pressure shot. He stayed still this time though.
Yes, Kurt.
And it goes.
Come on, Kurt. Come on, mate.
And it's a big error from Sacco. Kurt had two balls left in one section of the table, and Sacco didn't take advantage of it, so that'll hurt. A very similar position in this match too.
What's happened there? So the first fly we've seen in Darwin, I decided to get in the way when McCartney's on the black.
Mick's a pretty smart bloke when it comes to his heading format. He'll know he has to just forget that and get on with it.
Yeah, exactly right.
Everyone's finishing the frames at the same time, which is very nice of them to do. So we can give the sponsors a plug here. I've really enjoyed this venue, Jamie. Katerina Sports Club.
I've enjoyed the room with the aircon.
I don't mind the heat, mate. So I know if it's pretty warm and I'm feeling it. I know most people are feeling it worse than me, so yeah. That makes me happy.
I started off not minding it, but I've got to be honest, I'm pretty over it now.
Yeah.
But I'll just take a couple more days before I get really over it.
That's good, mate, because we need you. All right. Kurt's taking yellow. There's a pretty good opportunity here for Kurt.
Tell you what, I know this sounds uncharacteristic.
He may just knock this over the hole.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just put the screws back on Steve and say, listen, I want to be 5-all. That's what he's done.
See that straight in.
He's tried to pot it. And he points at it with his cues to say, what's going on there?
Yeah, that was receive. Not happy with the shot, bit of the fencer. Bit of the Errol Flynn, mate.
There's...
The Buccaneer is from Tassie too.
So the reason Kurt's taking so long here is he hadn't even given a thought as to what he was going to do after that last shot because he thought he'd be over the hole.
So he's going to take the double on. That looks pretty good. Ooh. But pretty good's not awesome, so...
No, but I don't see Steve Saxon potting out from here.
No.
Come on,
Ballsy. He's got a lot of work to do. Mind you, Jamie, if the yellows, yeah, it's pretty far up the rail, but if you can manage to move it, they are all there. Jake on the reds here, mate.
Yeah, he's got just one neat positional shot to play.
Yeah. It was always rolling into that area. So.
Yeah, he will pop the ball. Well, actually, this can still go both ways here, but I would expect him to pop the ball in the middle and screw out just because if he screws right out, he can't not be on the red.
Yeah.
Whereas the other shot's a judge of pace.
Chris Snare's got a tricky little shot here. If he gets it, he should go game. He's played it very carefully and well.
And he's taken it up to Steve Craig. I honestly did think that was a bit one-sided affair, but I love being proved wrong. Well,
there's a two-frame swing where Steve's potted that black out of turn. Oh, not out of turn, sorry. Off the out of the snooker and clip the red first. Bit of a pressure shot off the cush, but he should be right.
And that's perfect for McCartney.
And it looks like we're going 7-all here. Chris has knocked it in, so he should be 5-4 down against Steve.
I think this was off the break, wasn't it?
No. And no mistake there, so 7-all, Jake and Scary.
And how crucial is that last frame going to be now?
Alright, Kurt Dunham, still on the yellows.
These have been open right up.
I know why I said still on the yellows. Like they were going to swap mid-frame. That's a great shot.
Oh, has he landed on the double?
He's perfect on a double.
I need to see the table itself.
Yeah, he's spot on, mate. It's a great shot. If you can just run through and leave the white roundabout to that same area. Be a very happy boy. No fencing needed.
I'll tell you something else too. This is I know it's the second year. I can't remember the previous years, but there were three Victorians in the semis last year. There are this year as well.
Yeah.
I honestly believe a lot of that is attributed to the number of tournaments in the state. More tournaments than any other state. And that means you get a lot more match toughness. So if you're from another state and you're wondering why maybe, you know, you've got the talent in your state, but your boys just aren't getting over the line. Get more tournaments going over your way because, hell, you'll probably even get some interstaters over there.
Mate, we play that many comps and tournaments that I've almost had to stop playing in any snooker tournaments. I'm playing every other weekend. It's flat out.
Yeah, we've got the Barry Hearn of pool in Victoria now, Steve Jamison. Doesn't mind organising a pool comp here and there.
No, he doesn't.
And we've also got pretty good support from some of the girls. Like, you know, you've got JoJo and Wani, Tracy. They're all good organisers of tournaments.
Not to mention the great man himself.
Oh, well. Mate, he just turns up and does his thing. He's just a freak. We're talking about Dan Lynch. I think he's actually done more hours than anyone else in the room this fortnight.
For those of you who have been living on another planet and don't know what we're talking about, Dan Lynch. Oh, he's got to be too much action on it. Get past.
And he's bubbered that.
He's done a butters.
Can he swerve? There's a bit of gap between the red and the white.
I reckon he'd get around it to big target.
Well, the thing
the yellow's an inch off the cush.
Cushion first is actually not the worst result either. So
his target area with the amount of sight that'll be on the white ball is about a foot long.
Yeah, speaking of foot longs, he's probably not watching because he's not really playing pool much these days. But shout out there to Jimmy Miff.
Perry Perry Chicken.
We've been looking after Tanya for you, mate.
And just quickly on the other table, Scary's on reds. Looks
wow, he's coming off three.
Looks like to go game. He's got to turn this a hell of a lot.
Oh.
I don't think that was really the shot there.
Nah, I'm just wondering if the swerve was actually a lot harder. Maybe it was more full ball snooker than we thought. And Scary is actually looking very favourite to reclaim his lead.
And hit the hill.
Yes. Very important component of the match.
JR stepped his game up a bit over
this.
There.
Steve Saxon has chopped up. But he's got another shot, but still.
JR's just gone up 5-3.
I just beat
from 3-2 down, which is a great effort.
He's come over here as not even a player. As a temporary team manager, and now he's looking like winning the... he's a big chance to win the whole Masters singles. He's doing a Donny Cole, but...
He's come over here as a pool emptier, mate. Should have heard him get in it yesterday morning.
I actually saw some video footage.
People are running out in their balcony going, what the hell happened?
Colby actually got some video footage of Hunter. JR did a big splash and then Hunter tried to pretend to do the same thing and obviously didn't quite have the same impact.
Probably lucky he wasn't in the pool, mate. You would have been fishing him out of a palm tree.
He actually was in the pool.
Rio's gone 6-5 up. So this is a huge effort from her.
It is. Is it race to 8 over there, yeah?
It is, yes.
Yeah.
So Michael's just one good shot.
I can't quite tell if he's got the angle to get through to the bottom rail or not. Kurt plays a very good shot out of a snooker there. Just keeping the pressure on Steve after... I feel that he wasted those two shots a fair bit. Could have done a lot more with them.
Michael would have played this if it was simple, so he must have to do a little bit with a white.
Yeah, I think he's going to have to play off the side cushion with right-hand side. Oh, he's perfect.
It was perfect angle. He's pinched a bit of pocket. That'll be just fine where he is.
Tell you what, he just busted his fist out there for a second. He was pretty pumped about that shot.
Well, he made a big mistake earlier and gave up and didn't get a shot for that frame and the next frame, so he'll be pretty happy to hit the hill when he knows he should have been on it 10 minutes ago. 8-7, Michael Scary.
And I think it's his break, is it?
How much can you see of this?
I reckon you can see about half ball. Which is not really that much good doing. If you can just double kiss it a little bit closer to the pocket, that would be nice.
Just got to watch the Scary if you're playing too close to the red, because they can drift a little bit.
Yeah, if you can hit a three-quarter ball, he can get the double kiss quite nicely.
It's like he's on it.
He is, isn't he? Oh, well, there you go. He was on it. And he will take this to the top right corner.
Mate, after his last shot at the middle like this, you'd rather take it up the top corner anyway, wouldn't you?
Well, he plays his shots very well. That's why I've called it straight away.
And where he's put Sacco's red there is almost not potable.
So Mick's actually, in fact, breaking up, try and win the match. I tell you, Mick's actually got the break going too. He feels like he's actually cueing the break very well, and he's actually felt that he's found a way to consistently get a ball in.
He didn't.
And that goes straight in.
Now, when Kurt...
And he
Kurt,
punches the tape.
When he has nobody moving, Kurt does not miss those balls ever.
When you see the shoulder move, that's when he misses.
Yep. If he stays still, he just doesn't miss.
A good comeback from Kurt being at two frames in the rear, so still anyone's match though, that one.
Oh. And he's landed perfect on the rail now, he can open that ball up.
Yep, he's got a very good angle. He'll want to just try and come. I don't think he can come cushion first. Actually, the yellow's in the way, but.
Mate, I'm telling you now, he will be hoping this is his last visit.
Well, it could come cushion first.
It's a great shot.
Would have liked it if that yellow went to the middle, because it was just a simple link. Now he's got a bit of work to do.
Nah, he'll just screw back to around where the red is. He might need a rest.
Yeah, and also that yellow on the right side of the table on the ball line, just need to get on it.
Yeah, but if he lands around where the red is, he's perfect angle to get on it. He's underhit it. This is natural in off angle, Jamie, so he needs to do something with the white ball here.
So the way he's lined this up, he thinks he's missing the enough.
Well, it won't be by much, and if he misses it, if he's thick enough to hit the red. So.
I think he is actually hitting this thin enough to miss the enough, but I think he's just hit the jaw.
You look how close it is to the spot.
Yeah, I reckon he's missing the enough. I reckon he's hitting the jaw. There you go.
It's a good call, mate.
Oh my god. I've got one right, Butters. I'm actually pumped about that.
You're a genius. Well, this is his last tough shot here, mate.
This is. And he's a massive chance to win this match now. And that goes in. And he has a perfect angle to stun centre table for the black. And there is a gazillion people out there that wanted Jakey to win this match in the Australian title, but it's a mix taking it to him, and he deserves to win as much as anyone else.
Absolutely. Russell's just potted a black out of 10 to go 6-3 down against JR.
And he will take a bend in the toilet break, guaranteed.
JR's.
And he is.
JR's flying.
And the bend in the toilet break's busted out by the SA players. So Mick's just...
Well, apparently Russell Yulton thinks the toilets are soundproof. But he is gravely mistaken. Nah. I don't know if you caught any of that in the mics, but that was a great win for Michael Scarry against Jake McCartney, the big favourite.
And I'll tell you what, full credit to Mick for holding his nerve on that, because that was actually one of the funniest things that have happened this whole tournament.
Yeah, and he's managed to stay down at it. And Steve Saxon going back, back in front, 6-5.
So I don't know, you guys probably didn't hear that.
Yeah, Russell.
It was actually pretty funny.
Russell Yulton's walked into the toilets and he's just gone off his nut. Steve Saxon won that frame.
And everybody out here heard it.
And that was just... Yeah, that's one of the funniest things I've seen. Or heard, sorry.
And Scarry, in his first Australian singles final, will be buzzing. And that was a very, very good match to watch. And now, we get two?
He came here with two goals. First one being the teams, obviously, and the second one being the singles. And both are still alive.
Yeah, and like a true team man, his number one focus was actually the teams.
Of course it is. And not a doubt in any of our minds what his main goal is.
The singles was just a bonus to him. And that is a true team player, right? And I can guarantee you, right? I've played in a lot of sides of Scarry, and he's very much a big team man.
He is indeed.
Played one.
And thank you once again to our sponsors and the Casuarina Club. Without whom, it wouldn't all be possible, Jamie.
That's right.
Chris Nair, good opportunity to draw even with Steve Gray.
I just want to have a quick look at Russell and just see if he's bright red or not. No, he takes a swig of his Coke. He looks all right. Oh, and JL's dumped the white.
Steve Halliday's just told me that he reckons Steve Gray's on 6 frames. Steve Halliday, a mate from Latrobe Valley. Good friend of Steve Gray's. I'll get someone to double check that.
And Steve Halliday probably hasn't missed a single shot in this match, or in this stream so far, so he's probably right.
I'm just getting me boundary runner, Nathan the Hammer Harris, to go and check for us.
We've got about 35 boundary runners at this time.
We do. It's about time I'm not doing it all by myself.
will be 6-5 if he gets this yellow.
Well, I'll tell you what, these look pretty good. Just a couple to work out there.
I'll tell you what, good to see some representation from Tassie too. I really like Tassie.
Well, I know Chris too, mate. He's a very good bloke. And great to see him there. And a couple of years ago, he was Masters team manager. This year, he's in the open side. And in the semis of the Masters singles, so huge effort. Playing against the hands-down favourite for the tournament.
Now this out here, Butters. Saxon must get this out. And that's overplayed.
He's all right. You just roll into it. Oh,
I think it's a...
Needs a bit of a result. He might have to... He might have to force it and play the red into the yellow and run the white up a bit higher.
Yeah, and then he'll be okay. This can go wrong, though, for sure.
Yeah, it can. If it sneaks past the yellow, he's got nothing. Bill Vessel is saying Jake's been unlucky several times on the break. Jake was a bit unlucky on the break a few times, but he made enough errors.
Well, he's actually given that enough to give it a chance to get open table.
Yep. All right, we have confirmation it is 6. Sorry, everyone, that's Dan's fault, not ours. I can say that because he won't put on a mic and defend himself. He can turn mine off, though.
It's a big shot here in the context of this match for Steve Saxon, and he has missed.
No. That never looked like going. The body went a bit soft on that one.
And
Kurt's got an opener.
Plenty of support too here for Kurt at the moment. Pretty much a whole sea of Vicks on one table. And I'll tell you something
Lindell,
else.
Lindell 6-3 up.
This is another thing I like about the Tassie guys. They're out of this tournament in the open, and probably the girls as well. I'm not 100% sure of that, but they could have all just gone out and got up right on it last night, but they've actually got more representation in the room than any other state.
And they're wearing their shirt too, mate.
And wearing their shirt, so they're...
Wow.
I've got to be fair, that's a poor shot.
Yeah, he could have played it off the back cushion and done that safely without putting any work on it, so...
I mean, a touch unfortunate, catch the exact angle, but it's not a good shot.
Yeah, it was an easy extraction off the top cush.
Well, I mean, if he's actually feeling good, he doesn't actually have to extract it either. You know, he can get behind it and play it down the rail. There's so many things that can be done differently.
Yeah, but this is a huge opportunity for Steve.
It's a potential turning point in the match, that.
Good shot.
I shouldn't say turning point because he's already got the lead, but I mean a blowout, you know, it could potentially really ruin Kurt.
That means Kurt needs 3 frames in a row, mate. I know it doesn't. I can't count. I used to be good at counting. Don't know what happened. So 2 on the black.
You stopped drinking.
That's what it is. You're going with the buffalo theory there, Jamie.
I am.
For those of you who don't know what the buffalo theory is, it's the reason people are smarter when they drink. So the herd of buffalo, the slower ones get killed off and it speeds the herd up. So when you drink, you kill off your slow brain cells and your brain speeds up. And if you believe that, you drink too much.
And if Steve Saxon there has actually punched every one of those balls in, which means he's got his confidence
right
up.
He's feeling good. He's looking pretty determined.
He always is too, and he will take a quick break.
The last couple of the frames are the hardest ones to get, Jamie, we know that.
Yeah, well, that's true.
7-3 to JR.
Well, he should not lose that match from here.
Chris Snare at the table.
This looks weird because the scores are around the wrong way now.
Just Dan Lynch playing more mind games with Jamie and I. Yeah, it's good. There we go. So those scores are correct for the tables they're closest to. So those last few frames have gone pretty quick for JR and Russell York. Especially for those two. JR not known for his attacking game.
I'm just going to make a quick phone call. Back shortly.
This is a very good break from Steve Saxon. And he's taking yellows. He's got a couple to work out, but it's a good opportunity. Break this one touch and the red out. It's not real flash for him. That will pot into the same pocket as the ball he's about to play though. Still a good opportunity. He would have liked to be playing the ball he was lining up. That's the ball there he's lining up that he would have liked to play after this one. He may have blocked the path, but I don't think so. He's just checked it. Yeah, going for the middle. A little bit more angle than he would have liked. Looked a bit straight on that so he could hold. He may even have to play this up the table. That's a very good recovery shot.
7-5.
Rio Bolton, 7-5 up from 4-1 and down. This is massive. And 5-2 down, I heard. So five frames in a row in the semi-final of the Australian. The only bigger stage is the next round, so. Yeah, he's got his tail up, Steve. He's playing well here. Worked these out pretty well, Jamie.
He has. Still some work to do. I'm assuming that black pass at the bottom right corner as well.
Yeah, I think so.
Playing this, because he's actually starting to strike
everything in. The ball really well, yeah.
That's actually bad. Look, that's a big problem for Kurt, that too.
Big problem is the four frames in a row he'll have to win it. It definitely goes in there. No way in a million years he hasn't checked that.
Oh, absolutely. This definitely goes.
And this will go into the back of the pocket as well, I reckon.
Yeah, the way he's queuing now.
He pinched a bit of pocket, but it's gone in.
But you can actually see him queuing the ball. He's getting right through it now. He's actually queuing sensational.
Yeah, he knows it'll take something special to beat him from here, so.
So, can the current Australian champion produce four in a row?
Well, look, it's in Steve's hands. You know, he's going to get opportunities in the next four frames. So it's just up to him to take them. JR.
Well, this black is
bit of a hero shot to win the match here.
So
he won't be hating it.
I'm not sure we want McCartney's head in this picture the whole time.
Jake thinks people do want his head in the picture. It's understandable. He's a good looking kid.
He reckons he's in peak physical condition at the moment, McCart. Look at this shot from JR.
Oh, JR.
That's the end of the match.
I reckon he was 3-2 down, wasn't he?
He was, and he's just ripped a new one.
3-2 down, and he's won six frames in a row.
and with Russell's help. And Russell's been a little, he's a little calmer now than earlier when he did a little buck out of town and a bit of U-Butes in the toilet.
Lucky U-Butes has got a few different meanings, Jamie, that's all I can say. Stevie J's having a ball watching watching all this, mate.
I don't like...
G'day, Stevie.
I don't like Kurt's body language there. He's head down. So Rio 7-6, she's on the hill. And she, too, is playing for her first final.
Lindell's 7-3 ahead.
Yeah, Lindell's...
So Lauren's in all sorts.
Yeah, Lindell's flying now. Actually, I'm surprised they played that many frames, to be honest. It's a good job.
Yeah. Well, then the other table as well. All right. Steve Saxon just belted the plan in to start off. He knows it's his to win now.
Yeah, he does. Big wrap for the back of the WA shirts too. They look great.
They do look good. That's a good shot.
Chopped that in nice and thin. He's landed.
Oh,
that.
He's landed. One awkward ball. Absolutely perfect. Stevie Gray with the big horseshoe stance. His body looks like a big arch.
I love watching him break, mate. He gets the angry Pac-Man.
Yeah. The guy's 58 years old and he still makes the open side every year. And that's all over. Well, I'll tell you what, how wrong have we got the scores? We thought it was 5, so everyone else is going at 6, and it was actually 7. So I don't know what's going there.
We'll just forget that even happened.
Congratulations, Steve Gray.
I'll tell you what, I reckon Steve Saxon's gone about this out the wrong way. But anyway, he's at a table and I'm not. I just felt that he could have played the ball in the middle. He just played first and just left the white there.
He's landed awkward now. Is that red stops you from just running this?
Well, I just don't like the idea of having to transition back to this yellow down the bottom again.
Yeah. Just quickly, yeah. Once again, congratulations to Steve Gray. Another final in the Masters and Chris Nair. Fantastic tournament and gave Steve Gray a real run there. So good on you, Chris.
Yeah, and JR, a bit of a surprise packet this year in the final as well. And we have an All-Victorian Masters final again.
Something different. Is that 3 years in a row, Jamie?
I think it is, actually. Donnie and Steve Gray played in the last 2 years.
Actually, I think it's 4 years in a row. Because the Gold Coast was as well, I think.
And an opportunity for Kurt Dunham.
Come on, Kurt.
One
or two frames here, and that confidence that Steve Saxon's got will start draining out of him.
And he needs to do what I've been referring to our team in the last couple of days, and that is up and about.
All right. This is a big moment here for Kurt, and he knows it. He's going to have to make the most of every opportunity now.
I know this one.
If you can't find an easy way to go, game, you'll be looking for a good safety.
Yeah, look, I think that is actually the last thing on his mind because he just wants to get going again. He just dropped his head a little bit earlier on.
Well,
he want to get his confidence back.
He needs to get to this side cushion. He's under hit that one, so he may have to take the one in the middle, which is not a good thing because with the red up the top of the table, you really want a good transition ball, and the one he's probably got to pot now is it.
Yeah, well, I think he'll probably play for the top ball now because he's got the angle to get up there.
Just do not land straight, and that's good. Probably just try and bring the white straight back down the table, leave himself a bit of angle.
See,
play the one on the black spot.
I'd actually play this off two butters and try and land on the right side rail.
I think it's not...
He's got heaps of angle.
Yeah, but it's a dodgy-ish pot. It is a missable ball. And if he makes one mistake, he's out of the tournament.
I think this is the shot. I really do. He's playing it. He's playing it, Butters.
This is a big shot.
That's hitting the black. And that is unfortunate. But is he still on the shallow?
Mate.
Actually, I'll tell you what. He might even play a little snooker now.
Yeah, he might have to now.
But if he actually gets a little bit more left-hand side or screw one or the other, he gets right around angles, lands on the side rail, and he's got that red, and he's looking real good. Now he needs to reassess. And LBJ, 10-year-old man, give us a quick look at the camera there.
Did she?
She did. She just had a quick stare at it.
30 seconds.
Kurt's going back door on this for a snooker. That's a pretty good shot.
Yeah.
The problem is, he hasn't really made his balls any better.
Yeah, but the beauty of that is he's still got the perfect distraction ball there.
Look, Steve.
Gus is pointing at the screen. I don't think he realises people at home can't see his finger.
No, he's got a magical finger.
You're not Richie Beno, mate.
Gus has had a very good tournament so far. Finished second in the stats overall, and if does not get a call up on that, in the top eight for Australian team, I probably will punch people.
Well, our team's gone pretty well, mate. I think I finished about fifth in the side on 65%. So I think at the top four in the stats were Victorians.
I expect four of them to get called up for certain.
Absolutely.
And three of them have just played in the semis.
Just try and drop down onto the other route. Oh, I know. She's gone safety again. He's just short.
He's under hit it.
Well, Sacco's probably going to get an opportunity at a double here. Or even...
depends if he lands that last shot.
If he can get an extraction.
And he's looking at it right now. He's going, this is where I want to land to extract.
Yeah. Pretty much plain ball, couple of shots, so doesn't have to do much. Position's going to be pretty much automatic.
Absolutely, and it's just going to be just getting the weight right off this second last yellow to the last yellow.
He's queued that well.
And even this, he can just play this plain ball as well.
So yeah, he'll put a bit of running side on it, I think, get down nice and close. You don't want to be sitting on the side cushion.
Yeah, right. He's actually stunning this a touch. Too hard, though.
Well, what did I say? You don't want to be sitting on the side cushion.
Yeah,
apparently he did.
I actually thought he was stunning it, but he kind of ran through.
The thing is, he only needs to nudge the black half ball, and it's out.
Very good shot.
That's a great shot.
What's actually amazing about the shot, he's actually double kissed it out.
He's hit that with conviction. He deserved the result.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Punching that off the cushion, so. Great. And a great win from Steve Saxon.
Yep, and he will make his first open singles final. And a good tournament once again from Kurt Dunham. Oh, just falls short.
To follow it up with a semi-final after winning, it's a huge effort. 7-7 Rio, yeah, so they're hill. So we're going to run out there and have a look at that right now.
Well, yeah, thanks for listening, guys. Goodbye, and stay
viewers.
Tuned later on. 2:00, the team's event starts.
Yep, goodbye.
This is 27. just going to shoot back now.
Right up there.